Welcome everyone for yet another test, of course, back to our trusty T2 Linux, because apparently it's impossible to stream from macOS. Who would have expected otherwise after peak bugs last night and that fail right now? Let's see how stable that is on Linux, because certainly Linux. Anyway, so what I tried to live stream a second ago, 150 or nearly 150 projects, services and products killed by Google. Nobody expected something else. And I found this interesting. Of course, I was very aware that Google ended a lot of services, but I did not really remember that this were already 150 of them. And as we have our weekly news show, which we probably will also do and have to do later today, this news show gets too long and I thought maybe it's fun to scroll over those nearly 150 projects and services and see how many we know ourselves and how many not. Let's just have here our OBS streaming here inside. Hey, amazing, zero drop frames. Let's see how long we can stream our over neighbor's Wi-Fi here from Linux. Certainly wasn't possible from macOS. I hope people join here for this fun discussion. And let's scroll. So the website obviously is killedbygoogle.com, because why not? And so let's start here. 2003 to 2006, Google Deskbar killed almost 13 years ago. Google Deskbar was a small inset window on the Windows toolbar and let users perform searches without leaving the desktop. It was over 2 years old. I think I remember and heard about this, certainly never used this, as this was probably Windows only or something. Maybe they were open source clones, but I heard about this, never used it. Google Public Service Search 2002 to 2006 killed over 12 years ago. Google Public Service Search provided government, nonprofit, and academic organization search results without ads. It was over 4 years old. I think I never heard about this, never used this. Rightly 2005 to 2006 killed over 12 years ago. Rightly was a web-based word processor. It was over 1 year old. Not really sure. Maybe I've heard about this once or so. If I heard about this, never used it, I guess. Google Answers 2002 to 2006 killed over 12 years ago. Google Answer was an online knowledge market. It was over 4 years old. Not really sure if I used this, maybe heard somewhere in some headline, never used, I guess. And before we continue, this is also for companies. Of course, Google is one of the biggest companies today in the world, multi-billion dollar company, obviously. And when you see they do so much, so many products and services unsuccessful and ended, you really have to wonder what is their profit margin, how much they overcharge for their core products. Certainly their AdSense revenue is running so amazingly well that they can afford 150 experiments that failed. Certainly many other companies would already be bankrupt by now. Google Video Marketplace 2006 to 2007 killed over 11 years ago. Google Video Marketplace was a service that included a store where videos could be bought and rented. It was over 1 year old. I think I never heard about that one. Google Video Player killed over 11 years ago. The Google Video Player played back files in Google's own video file format, GVI media format, and supported playlists in Google Video Pointer, GVP format. It was 12 months old. I think I never heard about that one. And as usual, leave me in the comments below which of those you heard and you knew and you used and you are set that were killed. Google Click-to-Call killed over 11 years ago. Google Click-to-Call allowed a user to speak directly over the phone to businesses found in search results. It was almost 4 years old. I think I never heard about that one. Zeitgeist 2001 to 2007 killed about 11 years ago. Google Zeitgeist was a weekly, monthly, and yearly snapshot in time of what people were searching for on Google all over the world. It was almost 7 years old. This I knew and remember and used. Actually, I'm surprised it was killed and ended. It was not aware of this. I took a couple of times, I took a look at that, but it is even a surprise to me. Time is running so fast. It's a total surprise to me that it was killed 11 years ago. It certainly feels like 5 years ago that I last took a look into that, but Yeah, so much time goes in. Google projects are killed. Google Web Accelerator, 2005 to 2008, killed. About 11 years ago, Google Web Accelerator was a client-side software that increased the load speed of web pages. It was over 2 years old. I think I heard about this. So the reason I usually did not used such products is that I did not wanted to give Google more data. So while I'm pretty sure I heard about this, I'm pretty sure I never used this because usually I did not wanted to give Google more data, and all my all the websites and stuff I access and such. Welcome to this live stream thingy 1118. Thanks for subscribing. Very amazing. I hope more people join. Usually they do, but certainly not the best time today, especially after so many failed live stream attempts on the Peak OS OS. But now we are back to my Linux and things are so far running smoothly with zero drop frames. So that proves it is possible to live stream over our neighbor's Wi-Fi, just not from Mac OS because certainly not a solid operating system. So Hello 2002 to 2008 killed almost 11 years ago. Hello was a service by Picasa that let users share pictures like you're sitting side by side. It was almost 6 years old. Never heard about this. I heard about Picasa, but not about Hello. So much to their market penetration of failed projects. They killed Google Plus. They're truly fucking useless. Our comments as audience. Here in the UK, uses OBS on Linux for streaming. Do you drink tea? I also drink tea. The other live stream was something, what was it, HPPA. I was even drinking wine, although we are not promoting the consumption of alcohol here. And today I'm here with my coffee, though, reading all this stuff. My coffee is already medium warm, especially after the macOS stream failed. Yes, streaming from OBS. Usually, as you see from all my past live stream on Linux, OBS is running amazingly, especially the Git head snapshot that I'm using for VA API hardware encode. I was really surprised last night when I wanted to peak stream, live stream peak bugs from macOS that this was not successful, because certainly peak bugs, but otherwise I run my own Linux, T2 SDE, Linux built from source. Usually things are amazing compared to commercial software operating systems that sometimes barely work. Yeah, we are getting, thanks for the comment regarding Google Plus. We are coming to at least one project that I'm set, or maybe two, but we have 148 projects to read, so there are still some gravestones to read to go. Google Browser Sync killed over 2006 to 2008, killed over 10 years ago. Google Browser Sync was a Firefox extension that synced information like passwords and browser history. It was 2 years old. Yeah, usually I don't, so I did not use this. Maybe you heard about this. Usually, as I said, I did not use such kind of cloud services because I don't want to leak all my stuff, all my tabs and forms and typing behavior and whatever. They even purchased AdSense from a British search engine. That is interesting. Yeah, maybe now that you say it, maybe they also purchased YouTube. By the way, back in the day when they purchased YouTube a decade ago, when this was, I thought this was a silly investment. I thought they get copyright sued all over the place. Slightly surprised that YouTube was more of a success than I expected. Probably I should drink more tea and coffee or something. Or gin and wine. They purchased a lot of things, even Android. As far as I remember, in the beginning, I think Android was an independent startup there. So a lot of things they purchased were the successful ones. And this is, yeah, so many things are a surprise. This is also why we do such kind of live streams, not only point out what kind of profit margin they need to rack in there for AdSense to finance all the failed projects, also that all those big companies like Apple's PeakBugs do not usually do the most amazing stuff. And hey, zero drop frames. So I really wonder why OBS on macOS is so unstable when it works on this aging Microsoft Surface with an Intel ULV processor. And yeah, whatever. Just another data point that our T2 Linux is amazing. I hope we are really live streaming. So Send to Phone 2006-2008 killed over 10 years ago. Google Send to Phone was an add-on to send links to other information or other information from Firefox to their phone by text message. It was almost two years old. You really wonder with some of those ideas, what are those ideas even necessary? Who would want to use this? As if you need to use some service to share information, really wonder what people are thinking to invent. Stuff like this. Google Page Creator 2006-2008 killed over 10 years ago. Google Page Creator was a website creation and hosting service that allowed users to build basic websites with no HTML knowledge. It was almost 2 years old. Actually, this reminds me of this stupid, and this is, by the way, not a paid advertisement as per usual, but this reminds me to this really stupid Wix. I already hate this name, this Wix website creation stuff that each time I watch someone else's YouTube video, I get this bloody Wix promotion, really annoying. I really wonder, sounds a little bit similar, but there you see stuff like this might be maybe successful, I don't know, but yeah, so much to new ideas like this annoying sounding product, not further to be named here. Search Mesh 2006-2008 killed over 10 years ago. Search Mesh was an experiment, no shit Sherlock, non-branded search engine that Google used to be able to play around with new search technologies, concept and interfaces. It was almost 2 years old. Actually, I think I never heard about this one either. Google Lively 2008 to 2008, did not even survive a year. Amazing. Killed about 10 years ago. Google Lively was a web-based virtual environment that provided a new way to access information. It was 6 months old. Not really sure if I ever heard about that one either. Dodgeball 2003 to 2009 killed about 10 years ago. Dodgeball was a location-based search network where users texted their location to the service and it notified them of friends and pointed of friends and points of interest nearby. It was over 5 years old. Also never heard about this one, so I'm really surprised that I knew I didn't hear about many of those products when I scrolled over them, but boy are those crazy products. I'm actually surprised that this one lasted 5 years long. Texting your location does not sound like the most amazing idea, but whatever. Grand Central 2005 to 2009 killed about 10 years ago. Grand Central was a voice over IP service that was acquired by Google, as so many, and turned into Google Voice. It was about 5 years old, so probably this means this was probably continued as Google Voice. Makes me wonder, does Google Voice still exist? So, by the way, some maybe later we come to some services, not sure if they are on the list, but there once was this Google Cellular service, worldwide Google Fi or something. I actually would have wanted to use that because it provided worldwide roaming. Just I think the included data was not very high. Otherwise, if it really would have included some gigabyte of data for worldwide roaming, especially before the EU roaming directive became into effect a year or two ago, roaming internationally was really always extremely annoying and expensive for me. Would have loved to use Google Fi if they would just have included a little more bandwidth there. Not sure if that still exists. Google Shared Stuff 2007 to 2009 killed almost 10 years ago. Google Shared Stuff was a web-based sharing system that allowed users to bookmark pages and share it. It was over 1 year old. And some of the stuff really doesn't sound like the most amazing breakthrough tech, like rocket science, but whatever. As usual, didn't heard about this either. Google Mashup Editor 2007 to 2009 killed over 9 years ago. Google Mashup Editor was an online web mashup creation service with publishing, syntax highlighting and debugging. It was almost 2 years old. Never heard about this. Not really sure what did this even. What is web mashup creation? Not even really sure what mashup creation should tell me. Sounds like websites, but maybe not. No idea. On to Flixcloud 2008 to 2009 killed over 9 years ago. Flixcloud was a high capacity online video and coding service using Amazon Elastic Computing Cloud EC2. On 19th February 2010, Google acquired Onto Technologies. This, by the way, I remembered because we were in talks of some, as you know, we did some Linux embedded stuff and back in the day we were working with some other startups that wanted some video telephony web-based service stuff, and we did some consulting and technology work there. And I think they've been, as far as I remember, they were negotiating with On2 for some video codec nonsense on web browsers and stuff. And so this is why, probably mostly because I remembered this. So for 124.6 million in Google stock after this purchase, the following message was posted on the On2.com website: On2 products, Flix Pro, Flix Standard, blah blah blah, whatever, something, not a paid advertisement here for Abandon, old crap, is no longer for sale. It was 9 months old. Yeah, not really ever heard about this either, except On2, of course. And of course, Google is still developing, I think, this latest Google codec. They probably did this for the patent portfolio to have this patent-free video codec there, open source, without getting sued left and right. Google Write Finder 2005 to 2009 killed over 9 years ago. Google Write Finder was a service that used GPS data to pinpoint and map the location of taxis, limos, and shuttle vehicles available for hire in 10 US metro areas. It was over 4 years old. As I'm not living in the US, no surprise there that I never heard about this. I'm really surprised. If this would be my company, I would usually develop this technology into other stuff, like other location services. I'm a little bit surprised that these products are killed so often. For me, it would probably, well, of course, if they are highly unsuccessful, then yeah, we'll kill them. Just that I would usually try to just change the service over time to into something more successful, but whatever. Maratech e-meetings 1998 to 2010 killed about 9 years ago. Maratech was a Swedish company that made software for e-meetings, e.g. web conference, video conferencing. It was about 11 years old. Not really many details here, never heard about them. Wonder if they probably, the team was purchased and used for something else, I guess, maybe, no idea. Of course, this list is already super long. Sometimes a little bit more information would be nice, but this is an open source list, so maybe you can send in patches. Google Search Wiki 2008 to 2010 killed about 9 years ago. Search Wiki was a Google search feature which allowed logged in users to annotate and reorder search results. It was over 1 year old. Sounds interesting. Never heard about this as usual. I wonder, but probably this doesn't mean primary search. I guess probably this didn't allow editing the order of primary Google search engine results, but whatever. Bump Top 2008 to 2010 killed almost 9 years ago. BumpTop was a skeuomorphic desktop environment app that simulates the normal behavior and physical properties of real-world desk and enhance it with automated tools to organize its content. It was about 2 years old. If this means it looked like a desktop and stuff was with gravity falling left and right, sounds like a bad idea to me, but whatever, never heard about this, no idea what it was. Gook 411 2007 to 2010 killed over 8 years ago. Gook 411 sounds a little bit like some American telephone call number, to be honest, no idea though. Here was a telephone service that was provided a search recognition based business directory search. It was over 3 years old, as so often. Doesn't sound like the most amazing user-friendly idea to me, but whatever, never heard about this as per usual. Google Base 2005 to 2010 killed over 8 years ago. Google Base was a database provided by Google into which any user can add almost any type of content, such as text, images, and structural information. It was about 5 years old. Sounds a little bit like Wikipedia, I guess. And yeah, usual, as per usual, never heard about this. Flick, Flick, 2010 to 2011 killed about 8 years ago. Flick was a review information and news website that used information from aggregated tweets to rate movies as positive or negative. It was 6 months old. Well, some of those ideas do not sound too bad, but of course they all, to me, reading this sounds a little bit like Google was desperate, not so many projects worked, and they might have feared that their primary business model is not long-term growable and sustainable, and they just tried out everything. But in general, you see they tried to snatch up here as much information as possible, like from aggregated tweets and such to rate movies. So as per the usual Google mantra, collect as much information as possible from everywhere. Apparently, real estate on Google Maps 2009 to 2011 killed about 8 years ago. Real estate on Google Maps enabled users to find places for sale or rent in an area they were interested in. It was over 1 year old. Actually, a friend of mine who went to the States to work for Microsoft there in Seattle, he once showed me a website. I was surprised because it's not as organized in Germany or probably most parts of Europe. I don't remember the website was, but there was another website where you could look up all properties with their last purchase price and sales history. Was really surprised to me to see this, maybe also to you. No idea what that website was. Sounds a little bit like that website. I'm as usual surprised that Google, with their market presentation, you really wonder why they are not successful. Sounds like a logical thing to me to have such kind of services on Google Maps. Really wonder why they always kill them before they can be successful, but whatever. Gizmo 5, 2009 to 2011, killed almost 8 years ago. Gizmo 5 was a voice over IP communication network and a proprietary freeware soft phone for that network. It was over 1 year old. Never heard about it. I thought, is Gizmo not some gadget website, but whatever. Google Hotpot, 2010 to 2011, killed almost 8 years ago. Google Hotspot, a hotpot, was a location recommendation engine that allowed people to rate restaurants, hotels, etc. and share them with friends. It was 5 months old. It's really funny that they kill the stuff after just 5 months. Not that you give those services some time to mature and whatever. But some of those things really do not sound that bad. It sounds a little bit like a mix of Pinterest and what is the other, or this Yelp review stuff, like recommendation. And but really, you really have to wonder, with the success and market penetration of Google, why are all those projects not successful? But maybe they should just simply give them more than 5 months time. Google Script Converter, 2009 to 2011, killed over 7 years ago. Google Script Converter was an online translation tool for transliteration, script conversion between Hindi, Ramanagari, and various other scripts. It ended because Google shut down Google Labs and all its associated projects. It was over 1 year old. Sounds like Google Translate. I'm not really sure why this is different than Google Translate, but whatever. And we have a comment in the audience. I was slowly removing my dependency on Google products. However, for some things, there's just an alternative. Maps, for example. Yeah, I agree. You have seen I try even not to use Google Search, like DuckDuckGo and others. For some things, for example, I nearly never used Yahoo, but I still find if I sometimes need to look up some currency exchange rates for our business, like US dollar and such, I find Yahoo Finance currency conversion stuff and maybe even shares. So I don't own any shares, but sometimes I look up some shares like Apple or Google just for the fun of it. I find this Google Finance service not too bad. And what is funny is, and by the way, I have also nearly no Google products and such. This is, by the way, also why I historically did not use Google Android and still run on this old iPhone, as you see in all my other videos and live streams. So I don't buy the new ones because headphone jack and overpriced ripping off European customers or rest of world customers. And I feel ripped off doing embedded Linux stuff for 20 years. And then Google comes along and cashes in all the money for selling Google Android to the masses and other phone companies. So this is one of the reasons why I never was the greatest fan of Google Android. And so I don't really use Google much, not even Google Mail. I have a Google Mail account, or you'll see YouTube obviously, but I don't use Google Mail. Obviously we have our own email service and I always used my own email server and such, even for 20 years nearly already. And Google Mail I only use for testing, like when I need to send a test email, I tinker with our email setup, some all this DNS, whatever the whitelisting PFS there is, or what it is, don't even, unless I look it up, forget the names already of all the complicated annotation stuff there. So yeah, not even using Google Mail, only for testing. So Google Real-Time Search, 2009 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google real-time search provided live search results from Twitter, Facebook and news site. It was over 1 year old. I think I might have heard about this as so often never used it. Google image swirl, and by the way, this is not a paid advertisement for Google. This is mostly making fun out of 150 allegedly failed and killed Google products. Google Image Swirl 2009 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Image Swirl was an enhancement to the image search tool that came out of Google Labs. It built on top of image search, and by grouping images with similar visual and semantic qualities, it was over 1 year old. Not really sure if I use this. I sometimes use Google Image Search. I'm actually surprised how bad it works. Sometimes I even search for similar. I think it still works in Google Image Search to search for similar images, but somehow I'm usually not very satisfied with the Google Image Search results. Maybe also because the web becomes such a chaos, but that is Google's search problem, not mine. Google Directory 2000 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Directory was an internet web directory organized into 14 main categories that allowed users to explore the web. It was over 11 years old. Probably not really used it, not really sure if I heard about this. Sounds a little bit, so some of the things sound of course like other products. This sounds a little bit like Reddit, of course not entirely like Reddit. And by the way, my opinion of Reddit probably could be a topic of another video. Today this live stream will be long enough reading all of this. Google Rebang 2007 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Rebang was a zeitgeist-like service centered on providing service to a Chinese audience. It was incorporated into Google Labs as of late 2010 and later discontinued along with the parent project. It was over 4 years old. You wonder a little bit why, if it was similar to Zeitgeist, why it was different, but maybe for Chinese, but could they not run it in one project? I don't know. Google Labs 2002 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Labs was a technology playground used by Google to demonstrate and test new products, projects. It was about 9 years old. With such kind of things, you wonder why do they have to kill this? Why not let some, as long as you are a multi-billion dollar company, do you not want to have some Google Labs stuff running for experiments? But maybe they just rebranded this or reshuffled this into some other subsidiary of Alphabet, the new Google company, but whatever. Google Dictionary, did we not have a dictionary already? Was there not dictionary Google? Yes, Google Dictionary already. What? 2009 to 2011, another Google Dictionary. Killed over 7 years ago. Google Dictionary was a standalone online dictionary service. It was over 1 year old. Did it even kill? No, it overlapped, whatever. The fun and question marks of Google products and services. Google Fast Flip. 2009 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Fast Flip was an online news aggregator, something of a high-tech microfiche. It was almost 2 years old. I wonder why people would call it something microfiche, but whatever. I have absolutely no idea what is this even was. An online news aggregator? Was that not Google News? As usual, didn't heard about this. Google Desktop. Yay, a desktop I heard about, a project I heard about. 2008. 2011, never used it, so killed over 7 years ago. Google Desktop allowed a local search of users' email messages, computer files, music, photos, chat, web page viewed. It was almost, was over 3 years old. As per usual, didn't use it. However, of this I heard, but as usual, first, probably it was Windows, I guess, and I didn't use Windows. And even if it was for Linux or whatever, I would not have used it, not to give Google even more data. So no surprise there. Google Pack 2006-2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Pack was a collection of software tools offered by Google to download in a single archive. Download what? Offered by what software tools? It was announced at the 2006 Consumer Electronics Show on January 6. Google Pack was only available on Windows XP, Vista 7. It was over 5 years old. Sounds like not the most amazing product. No surprise there. Never heard about this. Aardvark 2009 to 2011, and by the way, correct me if I pronounce any of those funny names wrong, killed over 7 years ago. Aardvark was an social search engine that connected users live with friends and friends of friends who were able to answer the question. It was 2 years old. Somehow, it's so often not really something that rings too much of a bell or sounds the most useful to me. Google Site Wiki 2009 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Site Wiki was a browser sidebar tool that allowed users to contribute information to any web page. It was almost 2 years old. Does not sound too bad that you could, by the way, annotate and make markings there on websites. Just as per usual, you share probably all the websites you serve to Google. So something I would usually not use. By the way, although this live stream will be super long, I figure already, but all the other YouTubers and I, looking at my own AdSense revenue of a whopping $3 a day, I feel a little bit, how should I call this? I feel a little bit sad or something for other YouTubers who do not have a software developer income like myself, because certainly from the $3 I could not live. And when I read this kind of projects, because there are some YouTubers and I really find this sad, that promote products and not a paid advertisement here, so we are not yet a sellout. And I understand with $3 a day for our small channel, I understand why people, other YouTubers promote, take money and promote other services, because there are some really fishy services. And like, there is one service that gives you discount. I don't remember the name, but I've seen it in the meantime on 3, 4, or 5 advertisements of other YouTubers, where you get automatic discount code fill-ins. And I really wonder how the people, of course, maybe they need desperately money, but I would never promote such services. Is it not obvious to everyone that if you use some browser extension that automatically fills out coupon codes for your discounts on online websites for online purchases, does it not ring a bell to everyone that it shares all your information with those websites, obviously? I really wonder with what kind of consciousness and people can promote such services and even use them. But Google Square 2009 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Square was an information extraction and relationship extraction product that compiled structured data into a spreadsheet-like format. It was over 2 years old. As usual, don't even ring a bell here to me. Never heard about this, not really sure what I would use it for. Google Power Meter 2009 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Power Meter was a software product of Google's philanthropic arm, philanthropic in quotes, right, that helped consumers track their home electricity usage. It was almost 2 years old. It's a little bit, do you really need a Google service to look on your monthly or yearly electricity bill or make your own spreadsheet yourself? You really wonder, as I said recently in a live stream or something, smartphones don't make people smarter, only less smart in my humble opinion, because they play with Instagram and Facebook the whole day and don't do serious stuff like making a spreadsheet of their electricity or gasoline consumption or whatever, planning their future or doing something useful like walking, fishing, bicycling or playing tennis or whatever fun hobbies you would have made up here, only sitting with their dumb smartphone, but whatever. Zygote Body 2010 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Zygote Body, formerly Google Body, is a web application by Zygote Media Group that renders manipulable 3D anatomical models of the human body. It was 10 months old. Sounds amazing. Google Notebook 2008 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Google Notebook allowed users to shave, organize clips of information while conducting research online. It was over 3 years old. Not really sure if I heard about that, but why would you not simply use a text editor for that like I usually do locally? Gears 2007 to 2011 killed over 7 years ago. Gears, also known as Google Gears, was utility software that aimed to create more powerful web applications by adding offline storage and other additional features to web browsers. It was over 4 years old. one of the few products I actually heard about, never used as usual, but at least heard about, Google Buzz. 2010 to 2011, killed over 7 years ago. Google Buzz was in social networking, microblogging, and messaging tool that integrated with Gmail. It was almost 2 years old. I think I might have heard about this, but you see, even when I think I might have heard about this, not even sure about this one. Certainly, as usual, never used it. Apture, 2007 to 2011, killed over 7 years ago. Apture was a service that allowed publishers and bloggers to link and incorporate multimedia into dynamic layers above their page. It was over 4 years old. Sounds a little bit like this reactive layered website stuff that is currently hip and trendy. Noob, programming languages, no shit, Sherlock. Oh my god. 2009 to 2011, never heard about this, I guess. Killed over 7 years ago. Noob was a project by Google engineer Alex Eagle and Christian Gruber, aiming to develop a new programming language. Can never have enough of those. Noob attempted to blend the best features of old and new languages while syntactically encouraging well-accepted programming best practice. Noob was initially targeted to run on the Java virtual machine. It was almost 3 years old. Never heard about this. Has any of you? Google Health. 2008 to 2012, killed over about, I think this will be really fun reading this for 2 hours. 7 years ago, Google Health was a personal health information centralized service that provided users a merged health record from multiple sources. It was over 3 years old. Yeah, you for sure would want to give Google all your health information. Probably nothing bad can come out of this or happen. They would probably for sure never use it to advertise your shit and sell your data, probably, allegedly. Google Code Search, 2006 to 2012. This is, by the way, I used excessively. This was one of the few projects I was actually sad that they killed, because when I was looking, searching for compile errors or esoteric code lines, APIs, I used this sometimes, so probably once a month I used it in my open source work in our T2 open source T2 system development environment, that is the source compilation Linux stuff. Killed over 7 years ago, Google Code Search was a free beta product which allowed users to search for open source code on the internet. It was over 5 years old. Really strange that they killed this. I really wonder how much it costs them to run such projects, especially as they currently promote that everyone should learn to code and then you don't have a code search. Sounds a little bit like a failed opportunity or missed opportunity there to me. Jaiku, 2006 to 2012, killed about 7 years ago. Jaiku was a social networking, microblogging, and live streaming service comparable to Twitter. It was almost 6 years old. Really interesting to see that so many stuff were social network and microblogging. There you see that it is also a lot of luck to become successful. I think we came already by many social and blogging stuff here on this killed list. Google SkyMap. 2009 to 2012, killed almost about 7 years ago. Google SkyMap was an augmented reality star mapping application for Android devices. It sounds a little bit, I sometimes use such kind of free apps to look in the sky. Sounds a little bit like one of those. And you really wonder why they don't leave such kind of projects running. Can't cost too much money. Sounds not a too bad idea to me, especially with all the space hype as of currently, but whatever. Google Friend Connect. 2008 to 2012, killed about 7 years ago. Google Friend Connect was a free social networking site from 2008 to 2012. It was almost 4 years old. Yay, another social networking site. Can't have too many of those. No surprise there that this failed. Slide, 2005 to 2012, killed about 7 years ago. Slide was a photo sharing software for social networking services such as MySpace. Facebook later, Slide began to make applications and became the largest developer of third-party applications for Facebook. It was almost 7 years old. Never probably heard about this, as per usual. Urchin, I mean, sometimes you don't even know how to pronounce this stuff. Correct me if my pronunciation is off. Probably need to be Native American to pronounce this stuff. Killed almost 7 years ago. Urchin, does it sound Cyrillic? Sounds a little bit Russian. Urchin was a web statistic analysis program developed by Urchin Software Corporation. It was analyzing web server logs, file content and displaying the traffic information on website based upon the log data. It was almost 7 years old. Sounds a little bit like they purchased it, but no further information given here. Google OnePass 2011 to 2012. I think I might have heard about this. Killed almost 7 years ago. Google OnePass was an online store developed by Google for media publishers looking to sell subscriptions to their content. It was almost 1 year old. Sounds a little bit like what Apple is trying to do now with Apple News. By the way, highly dangerous. I would personally not sign up to those. Keep in mind that this kind of services take income away from publishers that already struggle. We had this, and by the way, we had this fuck and boycott article 13. Not a fan of old-fashioned paper print publishers, but the last thing I would do is give 30% or 50% of my revenue away to Apple. Total suicide move. I really wonder who would think that this is a good idea. Please don't support this. I don't use Apple News. Not a fan of Apple, not a fan of Google. All of those is a suicide of other business and society. Please really think what you use and how you use it, because a lot of stuff might contribute to the downfall of your local neighborhood and jobs and such. Only as per we had this already in the other live stream, make rich as rich and poorer poor. Probably also why so many of those services fail here. Google Flu Vaccine Finder, 2009-2012, killed almost 7 years ago. Google Flu Vaccine Finder was a maps mashup that showed nearby vaccination places across the United States. It was 2 years old. Now you really wonder this kind of things. I just go to my local doctor. I really wonder why you need services for this, but whatever. Probably if you are hip and on drugs in the Silicon Valley, then you need a Flu Vaccine Finder, probably, maybe. Allegedly, Google Wave, hey, something I heard about, 2009 to 2012, killed almost 7 years ago. Google Wave was an online communication and collaboration real-time editor tool. It was over 2 years old. Well, at least I think I heard now that I read this, not really sure if that is what I meant, but maybe it was Weave and not Wave. Maybe, not sure, maybe I heard about Google Weave. So much to the confusing names. Knoll, 2008 to 2012, killed almost 7 years ago. Knoll was a Google project that aimed to include user-written articles on a range of topics. It was almost 4 years old. Never heard about this one either. Needlebase, 2011 to 2012, killed almost 7 years ago. Needlebase was a point-to-click tool for extracting, sorting, and visualizing data from across pages around the web. It was about 1 year old. It's really funny. Maybe also inspiring. So if you look into project ideas, maybe inspiring what you could do and what might probably fail and what to maybe do better. Mibo. 2005 to 2012, killed over 6 years ago. Mibo was a browser-based instant messaging application which supported multiple M services. It was almost 7 years ago. That's actually not sound too bad of an idea. And to say something interesting, although it is already becoming too long, maybe we should try to keep this under 2 hours. What I also wanted to say and probably should make a dedicated video about is, I really wonder with all those apps, in my opinion, the apps for Android and iOS are a total fail. In my opinion, we should have rather went all web-based applications. This would be much more platform neutral and you could flip phones way more often. Imagine if instead of stupid apps that we would have made web apps as snappy and amazing, then we would not have all this vendor app store login nonsense and probably a much more thriving tech landscape. In my opinion, maybe leave in the comments what you think about this one. Google Video, 2005 to 2012, killed over 6 years ago. Google Video was a free video hosting service from Google, similar to YouTube, that allowed video clips to be hosted on Google servers and embedded on other websites. It was over 7 years old. I wonder a little bit, but this is of course the usual from the big companies. Not everything is successful. I think probably they tried to copy YouTube or something, and then in the end they had to purchase YouTube or something like that. At least this is slightly how I remember that. Correct me if I'm wrong. But there you see, these big companies often need to purchase these other services, otherwise they are not competitive. Postini, 1999 to 2012, killed over 6 years ago. Postini was an email web security and archiving service that filtered email, spam and malware before it was delivered to a client's mail server. Email archiving, it was about 13 years old. As per usual, never heard about this, wouldn't use it. Sounds like all the email would go through Google, something I would not want in the first place. Google Insight for search, I think I used this one though. 2008 to 2012, killed over 6 years ago. Google Insight for search was a service used to provide data about terms, people's, data about terms people searched in Google and was merged into Google Trends. It was about 4 years old. Yes, I think I used this sometimes a little bit to look also how our products and stuff develop, how the like insight for search, how much people really search for it and stuff. Sparrow 2011 to 2012 killed over 6 years ago. Sparrow was an email client for OS X and iOS. They acquired and then killed it. It was, as usual, acquire and then kill your competition. It was over 1 year old. I remember one, not use this, not sure which one I remember. I think, was it not Mailbox or something? I think they have done this recently, just a year or two ago. Or was it Apple, or at least, or was it Google? Yeah, so many stuff. Even as you see, 150 here nearly. But even if it's today 148 for sure, next week it will be 150 at the rate they kill stuff. Google Refine 2010 to 2012 killed over 6 years ago. Google Refine was a standalone desktop application for data cleanup and transformation for other two other formats. It was almost 2 years old. As usual, never heard about this. Google Listen 2000 and 2012 killed over 6 years ago. Google Listen was an Android application that let you search, subscribe, download, and stream podcasts and web audio. It was about 3 years old. Never heard about this. But the thing, as usual, it's really sad that we need apps for all this kind of stuff. Normally, you can, of course, just embed your own MP3 and Opus stream on your own website and can play it natively in the browsers. Don't really need an app for this. Really sad that we need a bloody app for all of this nonsense. We probably really should stop with this app business for a more diverse landscape. AdSense for Feeds 2008 to 2012 killed over 6 years ago. AdSense for Feeds was a RSS based service for AdSense that allowed publishers to advertise on their RSS feeds. It was over 4 years old. Does not sound like a too bad of an idea. Never really, probably not really heard of this, but whatever. Google Mini 2007 to 2012 killed about 6 years ago. Google Mini was a small version of Google Search appliance. It was about 5 years old. Probably never heard about this either. Google Chat API 2007 to 2012 killed about 6 years ago. Google Chat API was an interactive web service that created graphical charts from user supplied. Oh, not chat, I read chat charts actually. Graphical charts from user supplied data. It was about 5 years old. Like, why would you not use your local spreadsheet, like open spreadsheet, spread something, whatever, Picnic. 2007 to 2013 killed almost 6 years ago. Picnic was an online photo editing service that allowed users to edit, style, crop, resize images. It was over 6 years old. Never heard about this. The name already, don't know, not really sure. Doesn't sound like the most amazing name. And yeah, as usual, it's really sad that you need a bloody online service and share all your data with them. And yeah, as usual, Google Cloud Connect 2008 to 2013 killed almost 6 years ago. Google Cloud Connect was a free cloud computing plugin for Windows, Microsoft Office 13, 2003, 7, 2010, and can automatically store, synchronize any Microsoft Word document, PowerPoint presentation, and Excel, and so on. It was about 5 years old. By the way, it would be handy if there would be a number, if as this is open source, maybe if you feel like it, maybe submit a patch to number those, and we would know at which of the 150, nearly 150 projects we would be. Also, do you see the recurring theme? They usually want all your data here. They want to get all your Microsoft data. Like, if it's not enough, like you give all your data with search and Google Mail, you also should share all your Microsoft Office documents with all of them, because can't have enough data of you. Google, hey, a comment from the audience, amazing. And by the way, thank you all for watching, highly appreciated. I would, by the way, love even more comments. By the way, if you find this list and chat interesting, maybe share it right now with your friends and family for more people to join. The more chat we have, the better. Would be, as usual in my live streams, I find this kind of audience exchange here amazing, audience contributions and such. Everything is about locking people in now. Yeah, agree. Total my opinion. There are plenty of web standards such as RSS people used to complain about, IE6, MS login. But when we what we have now is far worse. This is, by the way, not even my opinion with Google. And by the way, I agree. And I never used. I always tried to use Google at a bare minimum, like only search or something. And this is also why I criticize Apple. First of all, if this Apple stuff, you know, we have commercial we have commercial, as our embedded Linux project was not scalable, unfortunately, you know it maybe already if you're a recurring visitor and subscriber, we ended up doing commercial software for end users, ExactScan, OCR kit, Recompress for macOS, later Windows and Linux, you name it. And I used Linux desktop from 1998 to 2005 or 6 approximately, or 7, so nearly 2 years. Then I slipped a little bit into macOS for the Mac software of ours. Was not too bad, actually quite snappy. And I can, without any being trapped in any Apple reality distortion field, I can, with a technical undrugged, not being in Apple, on Apple drugs or fanboy eyes, say that stuff becomes way more buggy with macOS 10.6. Stuff was working quite well. With each new version of macOS, stuff becomes slower and more buggy. Last night I wanted to make a video live stream about peak bugs. Unfortunately, OBS on macOS was not as amazing as OBS on Linux here, although this Surface has an Intel ULV, ultra low voltage i7, and not a much more performance delivering Core i7 in my MacBook, Retina MacBook Pro from 5 years ago, something. Really surprised how much more amazing zero drop frames. I hope the stream is much more amazing from Linux. Just proving my point, and this is not even here some commercial Linux, this is my T2, built from source, mostly vanilla source, even OBS Git head here for VA API hardware encode for the video. And even at Apple, it is getting you logged in, not even your data, but as you say there, you said login, and this is exactly my impression on macOS with the Apple Watch. By the way, I don't have an Apple Watch with iPhone and iPad. I only have an old iPhone and old iPad because I don't like the new ones. I don't being ripped off from Apple. I like a headphone jack. I also don't like the new iPad. It's super overpriced. You get for the price of a medium spec iPad Pro, you get a really good spec Lenovo ThinkPad where you can really get stuff done, not like an iPad where you get no creative creation work, like a local spreadsheet and everything is cumbersome. With a ThinkPad, you have an amazing open office there and local control over your data, not all the app nonsense and stuff. And even at Apple, it's not even snappy anymore. It is peak bugs, it's buggy, it's not amazing, and it's only log in to Apple Watch, log into AirPods, log into macOS, all the ecosystem where everything is linking together, that if you want to buy a Lenovo ThinkPad or Dell XPS or whatever, no paid advertisement here, if you want to get into a PC because it's more amazing performance, more bang for the buck, better price and everything, and maybe you want to get into Linux or something because web development and server deployment and such, you are hindered. You are mentally trapped into this thinking ecosystem, locked in, and don't want to get out. And then also, when I tell on Twitter people that it's peak bugs and it's not nice to take a headphone jack away, then all the people who are still on Apple drugs and trapped into the reality distortion field fight with me on Twitter how amazing it is that the new iPhone doesn't have a headphone jack. Yeah, thank you very much. You can use it yourself. I don't need to make Apple more rich. And yeah, so Google Cloud Connect, yeah, so Google SMS. 2004 to 2013 killed almost 6 years ago. Google SMS lets you text questions, including weather, sports, scores, and more to 566443. What does it even make up? Is this a number for Google, whatever, and get an answer back? It was over 8 years old. Sounds a little bit like old-fashioned technology to me. I grew up with SMS, I never used it not much, probably in my whole life, I probably sent less than 20 or certainly less than 50 SMS, I hope, probably even less than 30, I think, rough estimate. Also because in Germany it was highly expensive, I did not want to pay 19 cent or some bloody nonsense in the end of the 90s or beginning of the 2000s for a stupid 160 character text message. And in general, I had better things to do than text this nonsense. Just some coffee, so probably need tea later. Google Talk killed almost 6 years ago, 2005 to 2013. Often remembered as GChat. Hey, I heard about GChat. So Google Talk was a messaging service for both text voice using XMPP. Google later replaced Google Talk with Hangouts. It was over 7 years old. What I usually don't know is Hangouts really a successor to Talk? No idea. I think I did not use any of those. And by the way, a little bit side topic, but we should keep this under 2 hours. I used Skype back in the day a little bit, and then Microsoft purchased it. And what is really sad is how much Microsoft is destroying Skype. They constantly changed it into their integration of Microsoft services, and it became buggier and such, maybe with a change to Microsoft servers and services. And for example, with my friends there who migrated to Seattle working at Microsoft and such, I kept contact with him with Skype mostly, and then even he at Microsoft stopped using Skype because it became too unreliable and buggy and losing chat messages and whatnot, and that even he at Microsoft stopped using it. It's really sad when you have such kind of apps that you use to chat with some people and then you lose a little bit track and connection with them just because the apps become more buggy and ugly. And I also wonder what is wrong with Microsoft that they need to destroy Skype so much. They certainly did not have to buy it for such of money just to destroy it, but whatever. Probably time to use some open source solutions for that. Building Maker 2009 to 2013 killed almost 6 years ago. Building Maker enabled users to create 3D models of buildings for Google Earth on the browser. It was over 3 years old. I think I not really heard about this, but I heard that it is possible to contribute 3D models in Google Earth. But because Google Earth, I think, was mostly a Windows app or something, I have not even used Google Earth much. I think only later it came to Android. Maybe I used it a little bit on Android, maybe. But you see, as much as it is proprietary application, the less I use it personally. Maybe that's for everyone. Maybe leave in the comments below if you agree to this or not. And Nexus Q 2012 to 2013 killed over 5 years ago. Nexus Q was a digital media player that allowed users to stream content from supported services to a connected TV. It was about 1 year old. I think I heard about this a little bit, but as usual, I'm not really a fan of streaming with Google for giving all my data to them. It sounds a little bit like there are successor products like this latest Google Chromecast stuff, but I think they even killed that. So not really sure what is the successor of what there. Google Reader 2005 to 2013 killed over 5 years ago. Google Reader was an RSS atom feed aggregator. It was over 7 years old. So this is a product, so I did not really use it. However, just before they tried to kill this or kill this, I started to use a little bit because I became, so this 10 years ago, I became a little bit bored of, I have a couple of news sites like Slashdot and stuff like this and here and there that I browse each day, and eventually I became tiresome to load all the websites. And then eventually a decade ago, I thought maybe it's really nice to use RSS to have some integrated feed of all of those. Then you can just always take a look on those and only click on the news of the aggregated news feed of Slashdot and wherever what you want to read. And this is, by the way, really the inefficiency of the modern web, that it's only clickbait and page views and people want to get you on your site. And it's not really efficient for your time if you want to get stuff done and you search half of the day Instagram, Facebook and some other news sites, such kind of news aggregation, maybe even on your primary notification feed or something, would be really a good way to keep track of what is going on and only don't waste time loading websites all day and only have on one glance all your information. But as you see, it was killed. Probably this was too high tech for most people. Again, I personally have not used it very much. Just when I wanted to use it, it was killed. But in general, it didn't sound like too bad of an idea to me. Maybe leave in the comments below if you agree to this. By the way, in general, I have the feeling this RSS Atom stuff is not the most popular anymore anyway. Maybe also because websites don't earn enough then, and they need to get you on your site anyway to display you advertisements. Google Latitude, 2009 to 2013, killed over 5 years ago. Google Latitude was a location-aware feature of Google Maps, a successor of an earlier SMS-based service, Dodgeball. It was over 4 years old. Not really heard about this, whatever. As usual, try to avoid giving Google data. iGoogle, 2005 to 2013, killed over 5 years ago. iGoogle was a customized Ajax-based start page or personal web portal. It was over 8 years ago. Actually, now that I read about it, maybe I used it a little bit. I think at one time I clicked some weather and euro US dollar conversion widget on my Google home stream. I think actually now that I read this, maybe it was this, but not really used it much. But however, not such a bad idea to have some widgets on your Google search or landing page, though. I really wonder why some of the stuff is not successful and getting killed, but whatever. Maybe also shitty integrated and whatever. Google Checkout, I think I heard about this one though. 2006, 2013, killed over 5 years ago. Google Checkout was an online payment processing service provided by Google aimed at simplifying the process of paying for online purchases. It was discontinued on November 20, 2013, and the service moved to Google Wallet. It was over 7 years old. By the way, maybe leave in the comments below. We are currently for our own small online store for our commercial web, not web, apps, ExactScan, OC Arcade, Recompress, and such, you name it. We are using PayPal, maybe not the most popular because we do not want to have so many integrations of online payment services. Maybe leave in the comments below which of the online payment services you like most. We don't like to process credit cards ourselves because for German companies it's not the most cheap and simple integration. And in general, we do not really want to deal with credit card information. This is why we use PayPal, not a paid advertisement. Just a plug here, shameless self-advertising plug for collecting your input. If you have any preferences of online payment services, maybe leave it in the comments or chat below. Google Currents, 2011 to 2013, killed over 5 years ago. Google Currents was a social magazine app by Google. Hey, again, social, can't have enough social and magazine and such, which was replaced with Google Play Newsstand. It was almost 2 years old. Yeah, Currents doesn't sound the most amazing to me. Newsstand already sounds better, but whatever, don't really use any of those. Google Offers, 2011 to 2014, killed over 5 years ago. Google Offers was a service offering discounts and coupons. Hey, that was similar to what I mentioned quite some time ago of those other YouTube influencers promoting this other coupon autofilling nonsense that I would not use for not sharing all my website data. Initially, it was a deal of the day website similar to Groupon. It was over 2 years old. By the way, Groupon, another web service I don't like very much. This is also totally destroying business in my opinion. This Groupon nonsense, not a paid advertisement here as per usual. I remember I Google, James writes, he remembers I Google, it had a few widgets that were useful, but one couldn't see the usual Google doodles, only a bland logo, if I remember correctly. Yeah, not that the doodles were the most important, but such kind of, yeah, you see then people don't use it because of one small thing. In general, by the way, my grief with those companies, I tried a couple of times, and this is also a huge disconnect when people call my company Exacode, they call also support, which by the way, I don't prefer. If you want support from us, please write an email, because I usually also don't call to Apple, Google, and Microsoft. This is really funny that people usually would not call Microsoft or Google, but they call small companies and get on the nerves for 20 minutes for no good reason. Please really write an email. And when I tried to contact companies in the last years, so for the first 20 years of my IT stuff, when I was a student, when I was at school and students, the first 15 years, I never called a company. It could not even come to my mind when I was 16 and at school, Windows, using Windows 3. Or later actually purchased a student license of Windows 95, Windows NT 4 bundle for only 99 Deutschmark or something, or maybe even less. Something dirt cheap was really nice. It could I would, it would nearly never, it could not come to my mind to just pick up the phone and call Microsoft and tell them, hey, I have here a problem with Windows NT 4, can you help me? We usually solved our stuff ourselves and learned a lot by this, and I would not even have expected Microsoft to give us good support or any support or whatsoever. And the same is, if you want support for Google and Microsoft, if you call them, you don't get good support. They only babble uncontrolled bullshit. I tried this, for example, even with Amazon, with this AdSense, I had some questions. I called called Amazon for this AdSense because we had some integration challenges, because usually this stuff doesn't work very well. Totally lousy support. And by the way, they never can do anything. They only read stuff off their help system. And well, Apple tries to do something, but you have seen with my previous videos, it also took 10 calls to get my charger replaced that burned it, and similar stuff. And even my Retina MacBook Pro, the first one I had this image retention problem, and because it was a company purchase, Apple even tried to get away with this warranty extended display retention problem, because it was after the first year. My problem was, I made a case at Apple and they said, yes, okay, this is the image retention burn-in problem, yes, you get a new screen. And then I waited because I was on business travel. That was before my YouTube. I flew somewhere each week, a meeting there, something there. I never could give my Mac to Apple because it was my primary machine. And then after another 4 or 5 months, at that time my machine was 1 year and a few months old. And then also Apple had an open support case and they already acknowledged that it was an image retention problem and they were sorry, deeply sorry, of course. And then they tried not to fulfill the warranty. I had to call 10, 20 times. I had to really escalate this enormously and threaten them not to do any business with them any further and only buy PCs and install Mac as a Macintosh. And this will be the last Mac I ever buy if they do not switch the bloody image retention LG display there. And then people tell me Apple has the most amazing support. No, they try to get away with everything. And even if they have an extended warranty program, because then they tried, yes, this 2-year warranty in the EU is only for end users, not for businesses, it's business to business, and then you have only 1-year Apple limited Apple warranty without Apple Care, and they tried to get away with this, and I had to really harass them on the phone and press this stupid display swap case through. And after this kind of things, on top of peak bugs, you really don't want to buy Apple products anymore. And then I'm really feeling sorry for this Twitter trolls who fight with me over a headphone jack and not fulfilled warranty swaps in an extended battery and display replacement program that are still trapped in this Apple reality distortion field. They are just a normal company that want to maximize their profits. So, Google offers Quick Office 2013-2014 killed. About 5 years ago, Quick Office was a productivity suite for mobile devices which allowed viewing, creating, editing documents, presentation, and spreadsheet. It was 4 months old. Somehow I remember this, that it was it even on Palms or such? Sounds a little bit like they might have purchased this, because I somehow remember this Quick Office was maybe not Google's company though, and it was available longer than 4 months on other PDAs or something. Bump, only real is exclamation mark, I guess. 2009-2014 killed. About 5 years ago, Bump is a discontinued iOS and Android mobile app that enables smartphone users to transfer contact information, photos, files between devices. It was almost 5 years ago, 5 years old. Sounds like another opportunity to snatch up your contact information, probably without knowing this, never heard about this, no idea about the implementation, not sure if it's direct Bluetooth transport or cloud transport, but knowing Google, for sure it will be cloud transport to make a copy of all your data. Certainly, I guess, usually. Google Notifier. 2005-2014 killed. About 5 years ago, Google Notifier alerted users to new messages in their Gmail account. It was almost 9 years old. You need a notifier to notify people about your messages in your Gmail account? Seriously? What the heck is this product even? Google Chrome Frame. 2010-2014 killed. About 5 years ago, Google Chrome Frame was a plugin for Internet Explorer that allowed web pages to be displayed using WebKit and the V8 JavaScript engine. It was over 3 years old. I somehow vaguely remember this, maybe read on a news site, but as I'm not a Windows nor Internet Explorer user, never used it, obviously. But yeah, whatever. Google Schemer. I have the feeling I heard about this 2011 to 2014, killed about 5 years ago, Google Schema, I hope this is how it's pronounced, correct me if I'm wrong, was a Google service for sharing and discovering things to do. Discovering things to do, you really need an app for that. It was over 2 years old. This is of course the new generation who does not know how to discover things to do, like going out in the fresh air and climbing a mountain or so, or sailing, bicycling, fishing, you name it. Slick log in. 2013 2000, 2014 killed about 5 years ago. Slick log in was an Israeli startup company which developed sound-based password alternatives, was acquired by Google and hasn't released anything since. It was 7 months old. Never heard about this, I guess. Bufferbox 2013 killed about 5 years ago. Bufferbox was a Canadian startup that allowed consumers 24/7 convenience of picking up online purchases. It was about 1 year old. Actually does not sound too bad, to be honest. I think we have something similar, at least from the DHL in Germany. This DHL Packstation, I guess, although I never used those, probably should have, but I haven't. What I use, however, is I use the Amazon lockers. You have seen this in a previous video, and this is still not a paid advertisement, because Amazon Logistics delivering in Germany is highly annoying. They come whenever they want. They can come as early as 8 in the morning when nobody is in the office, or as late as 21 when I need to stay alone in the office, do some YouTube stream just to pass some time in the case someone from Amazon Logistics still comes and rings the doorbell at 2100. Really annoying. This is why I use this Amazon locker nonsense, just to buffer this nonsense and not wait the whole day and have someone sitting in the office just in case some Amazon Logistics nonsense comes. And this is of course a difference if you order something with DHL or something. At least you know usually DHL comes between 11 and 13 or something in our office, and then you try to be there even if you have appointments, or someone, you leave some student or assistant or developer or someone there, or you of course then you go with others to lunch and leave someone in the office just to maybe some parcel service to ring. And this is why it is really annoying with Amazon Logistics. If they come anywhere between 8 and 2100 or something, then this is really annoying. Also, I wonder why this, and this where I really realize this American Silicon Valley startup company, actually Amazon is not Silicon Valley, but whatever, they are really not switched on and not the most amazing. Because if they would be the most tech and amazing, they would simply use their tech to schedule these packages so that you get them at some reliable time, or at least give you some notifications. Why? And there I really lose my confidence and vision here for this American startup stuff. Because why, if they are so high tech and everything, why do they not have some predictive delivery time? Why is Amazon Logistics not giving you some delivery window, like, hey, our Amazon Logistics guy or girl will come probably between 11 and 1300 or 1800 and 2100 or something, because their PC already know when they will be en route there. And I really wonder why the simple things, the service is so shitty. Why can they not do the most minimal, most logical things at hand to make this process a little bit more streamlined? I have no words for this. And there I really wonder why individual people in small companies like myself have better ideas than these huge companies. This is this lowest hanging fruit that they are not doing. And I once asked this Amazon logistics guy in Berlin, Germany, excuse me, can you not like somehow schedule like you come in the morning or something, because it's really annoying that you come here at 1900 in the evening to an office. And he said, yes, they also find this really annoying. Not sure if this is true, but he said his PC is sending him all over the place. So 1 hour in one corner in Berlin and 1 hour in another corner in Berlin, and at the end of the day back to the previous corner in Berlin. And if this is really true, I really have no faith in this Amazon intelligence stuff, if that is really true. What's this one? So the sample size is one, but maybe I should start asking each of those Amazon logistic guys if this is really true. But this sounds really crazy. But given that they come at any time, which of course we now avoid using this Amazon locker, but whatever, Google questions and answers 2007 to 2014 killed almost 5 years ago. Google questions and answers was a free knowledge market that allowed users to collaborate, find good answers to their questions. It was almost 7 years ago. Sounds a little bit like, what is it, Stack Overflow or something like this. Programming websites, maybe there was another one. And yeah, but it's, by the way, it's also good that not everything from Amazon is successful, and there's also Reddit and Stack Overflow and stuff like this, because otherwise we would have even bigger monopolies. Google TV 2010 to 2014 killed over 5 years ago. Google TV was a smart TV platform that integrated Android and Chrome to create an interactive TV television overlay. It was over 3 years old. Sometimes you are really happy that this kind of stuff failed or could. Hey, one thing I heard about, not really used, but at least I heard about this, 2004 to 2014 killed over 4 years ago. Orkut was a social network designed to help users meet new and old friends and maintain existing relationships. It was over 10 years old. Of course, one of the yet one another social platform, because never can have enough of those. By the way, zero drop frames, completely no idea why streaming on macOS was such a fail last night and earlier today, but at least our trusty T2 Linux works. A treat, just if you are thinking to use desktop Linux. Google Play, is this a fail? Is this what killed? What? Google Play 2014 to 2015 killed about 4 years ago. Google Play was an edition of an Android phone that Google sold. It was okay, because is the App Store not called or Google Play? Really confusing with recurring names. Google Glass killed about 4 years ago, 2013, 2015, killed about, I said this, Google Glass was an wearable computer with an optical head-mounted display and camera that allowed the wearer to interact with the various applications and the internet via natural language voice commands. Glass now only lives in it as an enterprise product. It was almost 2 years old. I really wonder a little bit, this is really promising, I really wonder, but maybe the technology is just not there yet with integration and battery technology, because this, I was actually thinking to buy. I only did not buy this because it was too expensive. I would have purchased it second hand on eBay. I think the initial list price was over $1,000, maybe even $1,500, something just from the back of my head. And I would have bought it used on eBay for maybe $700 or $500, but I think on eBay it was always more expensive than new, like limited edition, $2,000, $3,000. Don't spend so much for a prototype that is not working that amazingly with a small battery. And I really wonder, but then maybe the people also don't want it, or they just don't know about this. But of course, it was probably also too expensive anyway. But in general, this was in general a really nice idea, just that I personally a little bit skeptical to give Google all my information as per usual. But in general, this is so futuristic and amazing. But then again, I would probably make more out of this than most users who would only Instagram the whole day. It was probably only tech people like me looking up stuff like integrated circuit pinouts and other more interesting things on the internet, and most people would only use this to live stream and Instagram probably, I guess, but yeah, as the usual smartphones for not as smart pay people maybe. Bepa Pay, never heard about this one though. 2013, 2015 killed about 4 years ago. Bepa Pay was a form of electronic ticket platform in Nairobi, Kenya. That probably explains why you never heard about this. Developed by Google in partnership with an equity bank. It was almost 2 years old. I heard about, however, that micropayments are super successful in Africa or so on old dumb phones as far as I heard. So slightly surprised that this was killed, but whatever. Google Helpouts 2013-2015 killed almost 4 years ago. Google Helpouts was an online collaboration service where users their experience through their online collaboration service where users to share. I think there is some word missing, as this is open source. Maybe you want to submit a patch that their expertise through. It's probably where users shared or helped share to whatever live video. It was over 1 year old. Sounds a little bit like this new phenomenon that are YouTubers, I guess. But yeah, just a recurring theme that new experiments are not always successful, not even if you are a rich Fortune 400 or whatever. One of the richest companies cannot press all their ideas through. Maybe the problem with Google is also that they are mostly known for free search and advertising and all this other stuff people just do not want to associate with Google if they are not like a brand like Apple that is known for, actually I have to correct myself, was known for usability. Of course nowadays usability is optional obviously, and peak bugs, but maybe Google simply does not have such a market penetration in a way that people want to associate with quality products, I guess. Maybe the more I read about this, allegedly Google moderator 2008 to 2015 killed over 3 years ago. Google moderator was a service that allowed crowdsourcing to rank user submitted questions, suggestions and ideas. It was almost 7 years old. Never heard about this either, as usual. Google Catalogs 2011-2015 killed over 3 years ago. Google Catalogs was a shopping application that delivered the virtual catalog of large retailers to users. It was almost 4 years old. All this idea that you really wonder, you need a Google app for this when you just go, if I need some electronic components, not a paid advertisement, I go to Conrad in Germany and not browse a Google catalog, but whatever. Google flu trends, I think we had some flu vaccine stuff earlier. 2008 to 2015 killed over 3 years ago. Google flu trends was a service attempting to make accurate predictions about flu activity. It was almost 7 years old. Actually, I think I heard about this, slightly irritated that it is killed off. I really wonder why they cannot have such kind of running on one of their servers in the background, but whatever. Google X, I think I heard about this one, maybe killed over 3 years ago. Google X was an American semi-secret research and development organization, which now operates as a subsidiary of Alphabet Inc. It was almost 6 years old. If it operates now as a subsidiary of Google of Alphabet Inc., it was, I wonder why it is listed here, but whatever. Picasa, 2012 to 2015, killed over 3 years ago. Finally, something I heard about, at least never used it because I would not give Google my images, but whatever. Picasa was an image organizer and image viewer for organizing and editing digital photos. It was almost 13 years old. So yeah, not a fan of using Google apps to manage my photos, but at least something I heard about. Also, I think there was, what is this other, was it purchased by Yahoo, this Flickr or something? But certainly Google needs to copy and try to establish everything because market domination. Timeful 2012 to 2015 killed over 3 years ago. Timeful was an iOS, I think there is missing up. I think this open source list needs some patches to correct the sentences. Was an iOS to do, makes sense anyway. To do list calendar application developed to reinvent the way people managed their most precious resources of time. It was almost 4 years old. By the way, pro tip, if you want to have more precious resource that is time, do less smart, in quotes, not smart stuff on the internet, less Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, but certainly subscribe to my stream and channel here, you name it. And also, by the way, I think someone also purchased the German Wunderlist, which I, by the way, wondered that the idea was already a little bit strange. There was a German startup Wunderlist, maybe even Berlin-based. They had some to-do list application and they were purchased by someone, not sure if it was Google or Microsoft. Really wonder how you want to make money out of a to-do list application. This, maybe they also never made money. Where you wonder where my company has maybe more revenue than a stupid to-do list. To-do Wunderlist startup, but you name it, no idea. Maybe I don't just understand venture capital ideas that are not successful and only cashing money in for the founders of some stupid ideas. Maybe leave in the comments below what you think about this kind of startups. Google Code 2005 to 2016 killed almost 3 years ago. Google Code was a service that provided revision control and an issue tracker and wiki for code documentation. It was almost 5 years old, of course, similar to GitHub. I really wonder why they stopped this, but somehow there you also see the different develop of marketing and product awareness or brand name, something. Maybe people just simply don't want to use Google anymore. That is why GitHub became more successful, or also GitHub obviously was Git, and I think Google Code was Subversion or something. But you really wonder why Google Code was not successful and GitHub was. But whatever, maybe as usual, leave in the comments below what you think about this. Songsa, 2007 to 2016 killed over 3 years ago. Songstar was a free music streaming service that would recommend its users various playlists based on time of day and mood or activity. It was almost 8 years ago. This kind of, so never heard about this as usual. And I have to wonder, this kind of stuff I would normally not use. I have my collection of songs and I listen to what I want to listen. And usually when some computer algorithm proposes something to me, then I usually skip over this because it's usual random nonsense that I don't like. Really wonder why we need apps and algorithms for all of it. Google Maps Engine, 2013 to 2016 killed over 3 years ago. Google Maps Engine was an online tool for map creation. It enabled you to create layered maps of using your own data as well as Google Maps data. It was over 2 years old. Sounds like not too bad of an idea. Maybe that was a reaction to OpenStreetMap or so. No idea, never used this. Pi, I guess. 2013-2016 killed over 3 years ago. Pi was an work-centric group chat website for an app comparable to Slack. It was over 2 years old, never used. Google Compare. 2015-2016 killed over about 3 years ago. Google Compare allowed consumers to compare several offerings ranging from insurance, mortgage, and credit cards. It was about 1 year old. Did we not had Compare earlier? Some of the maybe recycled names also. But yeah, you really wonder why there always need to be a Google app for this. I usually just... But the thing is, of course, this is taking away from normal journalists, right? Normally you would have a news article comparing several offerings, and then you need a Google app for this also. Somehow brave new world. Somehow. Leave in the comments below what you think about this or not, because stuff like this, of course, centralizes more power at this huge billion-dollar companies instead of classic journalism. Somehow, certainly good that a lot of this stuff fails, because classic journalism, if they are not biased and fake news, and I think I prefer classic journalism over Google and stuff. MyTracks, 2009-2016, killed almost 3 years ago. MyTracks was a GPS tracking application for Android which allowed users to track their path, speed, distance, and elevation. It was about 7 years ago, years old. Of course, as usual, collecting as much data from you as possible. Google Now, 2012-2016, killed almost 3 years ago. Google Now was a feature of Google Search that offered predictive cards with information and daily updates in a Google app for Android and iOS. It was almost 4 years old, I think, at least I heard. Google Now, as usual, not wanting to give Apple too much stuff, didn't use it. By the way, I just realized the bitrate is rather low, maybe because the static screen compresses so much, huh? Maybe this explains why we have zero drop frames. Anyway, let's make a test. Now if we scroll the bitrate, yeah, now we have here 10 Mbit outgoing. Interesting. Anyway, so the codec is doing what the codec is supposed to do. Freebase, 2007-2016, killed almost 3 years ago. Freebase was a large collaborative knowledge base consisting of structured data composed mainly by its community members, developed by MetaWeb, acquired by Google. It was about 9 years old. Whatever, never heard, as usual. Revolve, 2012-2016, killed almost 3 years ago. Revolve was a monitoring and control system that allowed users to control their connected devices over a single hub. It was about 4 years old. Yeah, this kind of stuff, I would never use this Internet of Shit things and controlling my devices in the cloud. You want to switch on your light and the cloud server is down. You want to switch on your heating next winter and the cloud service was discontinued, and never do this. Actually, my father is using some, maybe German, I don't know, yeah, Homematic or something. I'm not sure if this is some international standard. I've not researched just this. This is some local non-cloud stuff which he is using for some lights and stuff like this, which I would probably personally not really use. But there you see the generation before me. My father is even, although I have to admit he is electrician, so he can just fiddle and install this stuff himself, thankfully. And there you see that some generations might be more engaged with this kind of thing, so much to the previous generation not wanting to try out new things, and I'm more skeptical and not really into this that my father is in, but whatever. But in general, I have no problem with a light switch, and if I need local light in the bed, then I can also switch on my LED light of my smartphone. Don't really need to spend hundreds of euros for connected bullshit. Where have we been? Probably monitoring Nexus Player 2014 to 2016. Killed almost 3 years ago, Nexus Player was a digital media player that allowed users to play music, watch video originating from internet services and local news, and play games. It was over 1 year old. Never heard about this. Hey, comment in the audience. I love comment in the audience. In the UK, they are forcing you to get power line boxes, IoT electric metering. Yeah, in Germany too. In Germany too, they made a new law, but, and this is also really stupid, the cheapest, I think you even need to pay them maybe 20 euro or some nonsense for the non-smartest, not connected bullshit. And then it even has a completely shit control interface with where you need to Morse code blinking with a pocket light, some Morse code into there for activation and some bullshit. And by the way, I'm pretty happy that in Berlin we don't have yet this bullshit. My father has one, of course, because they have a solar installation on the roof, just new, just some 3 years old or something, with a huge battery, some really fancy lithium ion, really some kilowatt hour of Sony, I think, battery. I probably will make a video about this, probably another month or something, because this is pretty amazing. They do not even have the best orientation of the house, and so not source orientation. Solar cells are east-west, and so not even the best orientation for the solar cells. This is why they historically have not done this, and they have only done this very late now with a battery system, and the battery usually lasts on normal days, the battery-backed power there lasts through the whole night, and in spring to autumn months, even, and by the way, this is North Germany, this is not Florida or Silicon Valley, this is North Germany, where the sun obviously is not the most amazing, and between spring and autumn they have, I think, 90% of their, or even 93% of the electricity use is covered by their own, not even optimal solar cells, and obviously they still have a huge surplus and feed. Even with 90% on coverage, the rest is only having the washing machine running and stuff like this, where, or the battery is empty in the morning and you start the washing machine and stuff like this. This is where the last remaining 10% come from, and I probably will make a dedicated video about this, because in general this is amazing and more people should do this. And even with this, they send probably, I don't know, maybe 60% still, because in after late days in the spring and first days in the autumn, usually at 12 o'clock or something, the battery is already fully charged, and after that all the surplus electrons go into the grid, and due to this they have a very fancy smart meter, because theirs needs to count the electricity or the electrons going back into the grid to the neighbor houses then. And yeah, this is why they have this super fancy thing there since 3 years or something. But in general, I don't like forcing normal households to have a bloody smart meter for no good reasons. If you don't have solar cells and a battery and feedback electrons into the grid. And where have we been? Probably Google Swiffy. 2011 to 2016, killed over 2 years ago. Google Swiffy was a web-based tool that converted SVF, Shockwave Flash bullshit, into HTML5. Sounds amazing, though I would have never used Shockwave Flash nonsense in the first place. Never have done. Never have been a fan, never will. Thanks God this stuff is also killed off for good. Web hosting in Google Drive. Oh, thanks God. 2012 to 2016, of course, you see the recurring theme. Didn't hear about this. Didn't use it. Of course, they want all your data. Killed over 2 years ago. Web hosting in Google Drive was the method of uploading HTML and CSS and other files in order to publish live websites. It was almost 4 years old. By the way, there is this new AMP, or accelerated mobile something platform bullshit. Of course, yet another move of forcing websites, news sites and services and such to host on Google, give them more control and data, makes them bigger and richer. As usual, don't do this, don't fall off this, just make static or not as dynamic or whatever, just make minimal websites without 20 frameworks and trackers, and you also have super fast loading websites, don't need Google AMP or what this is called for. Project ARA, 2013 to 2016, created over 2 years ago. Project ARA was a modular smartphone project under developed by Google. It was almost 3 years old. This actually I heard about, and this would be interesting. Imagine you can swap out your camera for a higher resolution one, swap out your battery for a higher capacity one, more like a modular PC. In general, that was amazing, or should be amazing. Maybe also killed because profit margins not high enough. Phone companies rather want to sell you a new phone. Google Hangout on Air, 2012 to 2016, killed over 2 years ago. Google Hangout on Air, Google's live streaming service, has moved to YouTube Live in September 2016. The service was originally created in 2012 when live streaming was catching on and once used by President Obama and Pope Francis. Yeah, wonderful, just what some, anyway. Let's see, next user, 1980 writes, I was looking forward to Project ARA, I like phone longevity. Yeah, this is why I'm still rocking my iPhone 6s and Nexus 5 for the Android testing. Not really into giving these companies all my money, obviously, for no good reason. And yeah, totally with you. And as I said, would be amazing, some PC-like modular stuff. And this is also why people like Louis Rossman and Jetha Jones and others soldering. And by the way, this is only, I would have never expected that you can repair an iPhone like this. So also even me learned something new, because in university and stuff, they always teach SMD repairability is zero and not worthwhile, and really awesome thing that Louis Rossman. This is also why I got into YouTubing, obviously, when I saw people like Louis Rossman and others doing their content. And this is why, yeah, definitely, totally agree, Louis Rossman, for what it's worth. And yeah, this even inspired me, this kind of things, not Louis Rossman alone, but also others, that to create a YouTube channel here and spread my tinkering and stuff. And I hope I create here some newsworthy new content and not only copy others. And we will not always read here over funny lists like this. This is just my funny Sunday morning stream, also testing here my neighbor's Wi-Fi, because we later need to do our weekly bit news stream of this week. And I also do this interim live stream not only to check out here how I should stream later on the go, but also otherwise the weekly bit news show would become too long if I would have included this 150 failed Google project list. And also we do this here to make fun, not paid advertisement, but fun out of Google for all their failed projects. If you have amazing management and execution, maybe you should not have 150 failed projects. And also maybe this should ring a bell to people and realize how much profit margin they have, because my company would not be able to sustain and live with 150 failed projects, and we would have been long bankrupt. And this probably should tell you how much profit margin they rake in there with their primary search advertising stuff and YouTube advertising. Google Showtimes, 2005 to 2016, killed over 2 years ago. Google Showtimes was a standalone music search result page. It was about 11 years old. Okay, whatever. Never heard about this either. Panorama, 2005 to 2016, killed over 2 years ago. Panorama was a geolocation tagging photo sharing mashup product. It was about 11 years old. Whatever. Never heard about this either. No surprise here. Google's hands-free. Maybe I heard about this one though. 2016 to 2017, what already killed. Killed recently, about 2 years ago. Google Hands-Free was a mobile payment system that allowed users to pay their bill by simply saying, I'll pay with, okay, wait a second, then I didn't hear about this, I thought it's something else. I'll pay with Google, what's a bloody fucking shit? You can't make this bloody project up. Who thinks this is a good idea? It uses Bluetooth to wireless connect to payment terminals, and that longer range means that you could keep your phone in your pocket. It was 11 months old, what the heck? Seriously. By the way, this Louis Rossman, I don't watch him daily anymore. Maybe a year ago or 2 years ago, I watched his earlier repair stuff and learned quite some SMD stuff. Even I learned quite some SMD hot air soldering. But I find his latest development a little bit funny. I'm surprised with his recently more funny videos. He has so many subscribers because maybe I should get a cat. My girl previously had a cat and she said maybe we should get a cat again. So maybe with streaming here cat videos we would be more successful, just like Lewis. And in general, this is also why maybe I try some random stuff here, just like Lewis. Or maybe I should live stream my telephone calls, but in general, a little bit irritated with Lewis's latest attempts to do random videos. Chromebook Pixel, 2013 to 2017, killed about 2 years ago. Chromebook Pixel was a high-end Chromebook laptop mixing Chrome OS with an Intel i5, 4 GB of DDR3 RAM, 32 GB SSD, and an amazing high resolution 2560 by 1700. 12.85 screen. Was this even, don't even remember, was this 3:2 or something? It was about 4 years old. With this, I have to say, I wanted one, so I would have purchased this if this would have been, I think this never was on sale in Germany, maybe not in Europe, no idea. I sometimes considered buying one on eBay, but the problem with this, I actually would have purchased something like this. By the way, I have not seen it once. Maybe I've seen it probably only once in person, maybe on the CeBIT trade show 3 years ago or four. And the problem with this is, of course, multitude. Not only was it not on sale in our region, as so often, by the way, often Google's Pixel and WhatsApp stuff is often very limited in the rest of the world, even in Germany. And then it was only an i5, but okay. And the memory, if I would have got this, I would have wanted to run virtual machines, and 4 GB just don't kill it for this. And then 32 GB, not sure if this was socketed or if you, knowing Google, maybe this was even soldered, no idea, would have need to Google. And the display, of course, was amazing. The rest of the chassis was okay. And with more memory and socketed, more upgradable SSD, I would have purchased it just to replace my laptop, my MacBook or something. But for this, I rather take a ThinkPad, and probably all of you should. And yeah, there you see, I was at the edge of maybe getting one, but not being on sale. Strange specs here, of course. And by the way, this is for people who use this as a Chromebook. It was really overpriced for this memory and SSD. I think it probably was quite overpriced for just being a limited cloud connected Chromebook like this, but whatever. And Google Map Maker, did we not had already multiple map makers? 2008 to 2017, killed about almost 2 years ago. Google Map Maker was a map making and map editing service where users were able to draw features directly on the map. It was almost 9 years old. Somehow it sounds like multiple other map makers. Of course, there you see, I already tried to keep notifications on a minimum here. Just got a notification here. Your fans love this video. It hit 10K views. Post it to celebrate. Like, seriously, what the heck? This is where I already keep notifications to minimum. This video is, by the way, not really sure. This is some disassembly video of some. Maybe I open it in YouTube Creator just for the fun of it. Which is this even? Because the thumbnail doesn't show it. Yes, and if I click on post here, maybe I just click here on post just for the fun of it to see. Oh, I need to type a text. Okay, this is the IdeaPad disassembly. Amazing. Maybe I just click on the post button to post on it. But you see this notification stuff is mostly engaging and creating even more posts for your subscribers and fans to see. And why I would not get an Apple Watch to tell me, I don't need a watch to tell me to stand up and breathe and whatever bullshit. Not a fan of this over notification connected nonsense. And this is also why we use hopefully our influence here for some good influence, not to over tech you out and instead also see something from the real world for your health and mental health and everything. Glass OS 2013 to 2017. Killed almost 2 years ago. Glass OS Google XE was a version of Android operating system designed for Google Glass. It was almost 4 years ago, years old. Yeah, as Google Glass was killed, no surprise this was killed. Trendalizer 2017, hey, it became 10 years old, amazing, killed over 1 year ago, Trendalyzer, never heard about this, was a data trend viewing platform, whatever, not interested, not heard about this, no surprise it was killed. Google Portfolios, 2016 to 2017, killed over 1 year ago. Portfolio was a feature available in Google Finance to track personal financial securities. It was over 11 years old. Never heard about this. Not interested in giving Google more data. And by the way, for all the loyal fans here, subscribers and recurring visitors, let's shortly drink coffee. And then tell you something else. I just remember, and maybe I need to make a dedicated video about this. We use Google AdSense a little bit for our products, and I'm really frustrated with this. First of all, Google AdSense until recently looked super old. I really wonder why companies do not keep their primary cash-bringing product a little bit more up to date. And then what I really hate in this cloud software stuff, you don't have undo, or for example, then Google calls you, and even we did not make so much advertisement because we are a small coupé counting Scrooge McDuck company. And then they call us and try to convince us to spend more money or change the settings. And usually the first years I ignore this, always, yeah, thank you very much, I have better things to do than talk with me, and hang up the phone. And then eventually after 5 years of 20 calls or something, I thought, and I was already not very satisfied with Google AdSense, I thought, okay, maybe I listened to the advice and I did some, then they told us, yeah, we had some combined AdSense for search and for display network and search or something, and they convinced me that it's better for search settings to split this for more control and better advertisement or something. I thought it's bullshit, but okay, I thought, okay, let's try this once in 10 years and see if advertising improves. And so we did quite a lot of changes, and advertising became significantly worse. Of course, I cannot be sure if it was we spent more money, we had less page views, so it was only maximizing Google's profit, minimizing our advertising chances. And then I called them and said, okay, hello, I let this run for 6 or 8 weeks. This is complete bullshit now. Can we please undo this? What you did with us some 6 or 8 weeks ago or something on your other advisors, nonsense here. And they said, no, sorry, there is no undo. I said, how can there not be an undo? Each bloody open office has undo, each desktop software has undo. No, why should there be an undo for web software? And this is why, what I also want to tell and maybe probably need to do a dedicated video about, with this web software, you lose comfort features that you had for 30 years in rich desktop applications. You had features like undo, and in web software, you don't have undo anymore. And even on such huge financial stuff like AdSense, you don't have undo. And then I said, clever as we are as IT developers and computer scientists and everything, said, okay, fine, but if you already don't have undo, maybe you can restore this to some backup snapshot thing. Do you not have any kind of automatic snapshot of settings or something? No. Why no? I mean, this is our business depends on this. How can there not be some, is there not a way to back up this bloody all this AdSense, or go to back up, not undo, but go back to some kind of backup snapshot thing or something? No, there is nothing. So you work for something, you spend thousands of euro, especially over the year anyway. In total, we spent over ten thousands of euro over the last decade at Google, and you don't have undo, you don't have backups. They call you and tell you bullshit that you usually ignore, and once you go with it, it totally destroys your AdSense setup. I ended up disabling or pausing all of those AdSense and clicking all this bloody stuff together, and it never worked as good as it was set up with our own experience over years. And yeah, just a little side story of bloody Google products, just that you have some more data points what you get when you use cloud software. Where have we been even? Probably here we have been. Google Chrome apps, 2010 to 2017, killed over 1 year ago. Google Chrome apps were a hosted and packaged web application that run on the Google Chrome browser. It was about 7 years ago. Sounds a little bit like Electron, a little bit Chrome apps. Sounds a little bit like Electron, but not a fan of Electron. I also, because of course browser applications are super small, I don't see a point to download 50 megabyte or more or something for this Electron bullshit when it's mostly a web process that you already have. So you install always copies and insecure copies with even more security holes and less regular updated. And then you have really slow and laggy web applications on your desktop. I don't see the point. I also once tried, what was this? This music streaming, this this loss, more lossless thing. What is it even? There are so many, I forgot already the names. From this strange rapper, I think. This Tidal, you know, Tidal. It is, and this bloody desktop app, I wanted to make a copy of some songs digitally on my mini disc player, and this bloody web application, this Tidal is of course Electron, and it could not even play gapless. In 2000, it was a year ago, so in 2018, you cannot even use a bloody music streaming service to play audio gapless. To, of course, I don't want to make you a copy, but even if you enjoy music, you can't even enjoy your music without gaps between the songs. This is ridiculous. And yeah, also what we need to spread the word here on this channel. Project Tango 2014 to 2017 killed over 1 year ago. Project Tango was an API for augmented reality app that was killed and replaced with ARCore. It was about 3 years old as usual. You need to probably watch the Google keynote to know how to pronounce it, probably ARCore. But first you say ARCore, what? ARCore, bloody names. Google Site Search 2018 killed over 12 months ago. Google Site Search was a service that enabled a website to add a custom search field empowered by... they discontinued this. I thought, do we not use it on the T2 website? I was not... Oh, wait a second. Website, a custom search field. So the... So our custom search doesn't work on the T2 website anymore. Maybe I should monitor our own website more often and probably not use Google search to start with. This is why I don't care if Google... yes, Google Stadia will be part of our weekly IT newsletter today, and I agree, and you probably want to share, like, and subscribe to not miss later IT bits news show tonight. QPX Express API killed 12 months ago, a service that Google developers for long tail travel client ITA software will create a new easy way for users to find better flight information online, which should encourage more users to make their flight purchase online. It was almost 8 years ago. Never heard about this. Not really sure. Whatever. Who used it? If anyone. Encrypted Search 2010 to 2018 killed 11 months ago. Encrypted Search provided users with anonymous internet search. It was 8 years ago. Never heard about this. No surprise, let's say, killed anonymous encrypted internet search. No surprise there, but whatever, does not sound like a bad idea, but probably hurts the advertising business. Save to Google Chrome extension 16 to 2018 killed 7 months ago. Save to Google Chrome extension enabled you to quickly save a page link with images and text to a pocket-like app. It was over 12 years old. Don't use Chrome. Never heard about this. In general, also not a fan of Firefox Pockets or something. I just want a regular, call me old-fashioned, but I just want a working and snappy and slim and lightweight internet browser, something that probably doesn't exist anymore. Don't need all these extensions and pockets and snippets and whatnot, but whatever, that is a modern internet. Google Goggles killed 7 months ago, 2010 to 18. Google Goggles was used for search based on pictures taken by handheld devices. It was almost 8 years ago. Think I heard about this, never used this as per usual, but I probably have seen someone trying to use it, but whatever. TESS 2017 to 18 killed 7 months ago. TESS was a mobile payment service by Google targeted at users in India. Probably explains why I didn't hear about this. It was rebranded to Google Pay. It was 11 months old. Reply 2018 to 18, not even a year old, killed 5 months ago. Reply was a mobile app that let users insert smart replies, predefined replies into conversation on messaging apps. It was 8 months ago. By the way, I recently seen somewhere, not really sure if it was at Apple or Google, somewhere I've seen smart replies, maybe it was even Siri, And there you see where our society is going, and I really hate this, and this is why I started my YouTube channel, to influence you a little bit in a more smart way. Because seriously, is this what we have come down, our relations and friendship, to automated Siri or Google Assistant, or God beware, Bixby replies, friends, like automated, hey, how are you doing, what are you doing, and then your assistants reply to each other. One assistant thinks you have not heard from someone, then your assistant sends to someone, hey, how are you doing, not heard from you in a long time, and then the other automated assistant replies, yeah, thanks for replying, thanks, all is okay, and you don't even communicate with each other anymore, and only your assistants reply to each other with, hey, how is it going, yes, thanks, fine, and people only sit on their sofa as couch potato and playing cloud streaming stuff, or I don't know what. Really sad. Google News and Weather 2016-18 killed 5 months ago. Google News and Weather is a news aggregator application developed by Google on May 8, 2018. Google announced that it was merging Play Newsstand and Google News and Weather into a single service called Google News. It was available on Android and iOS operating systems. It was 2 years old, whatever. In general, don't really need more than Weather. In general, of course, it would be better, instead of relying on big companies to do your news aggregation, to use your own RSS feed, but somehow something that does not exist anymore, or not much, but no surprise that big companies want to snatch onto the news aggregation and making money out of these services. Google Search Appliances 2002-18 killed 3 months ago. Google Search Appliance was rack-mounted device that provided document indexing functionality. It was almost 17 years old. I actually have seen this, probably only on the CeBIT trade show. If not sure if I would heard about or seen this, if I would not have seen this on the CeBIT trade show quite some years, maybe 5 or 10 years ago. I wondered back in the day which sane company would put a rack of Google in their data center for local document search, not risking that all this stuff is going back to Google servers, you never know, or to the NSA or whatsoever. You know the Snowden papers. Leave in the comments below if you think that is a good idea or not. Chromecast Audio, I think I mentioned earlier already on the very beginning of some other killed Google product, that I think Chromecast Audio was killed. I think there earlier was another audio streaming service, 2015-19, killed 2 months ago. Chromecast Audio was a device that allowed users to stream audio from any device to any speaker with an audio input. It was 3 years old with this kind of thing, so I always wonder why do they kill this. But again, Google is probably not very good in selling these devices, I guess. At least it's not very big in Germany, or probably the rest of the world. But in general, the small device does not sound like the worst idea. Google Allo also, 2016-2019, killed 11 days ago. Yay, we are getting into the daily Google killings here. Google Allo is an instant messaging mobile app for Google. It will be rebranded as Google Chat. It was over 2 years old. Yeah, rebranding of questionable, not amazing names, you name it. Google URL shortener, March 2019. Bytes the big one in 6 days. Oh, it will still work 6 days. Wow, amazing. So if you want to Google URL shortener, you have 6 days left. Known as Google is a URL shortening service. It was over 9 years old. I slightly wonder why do they discontinue this. If you have insights, would be interesting to hear. Because, so not personally, I've never really used this shortener services. I think mostly they are used for disguising where this stuff is going. Also malware and whatnot. And stuff like this, not really, but maybe leave in the comments below if you used URL shorteners, if you're a fan of those, and slightly wonder why they stopped this kind of services. Sound like they don't take much resources, and you could probably leave it running for literally forever as long as Google exists, but whatever. Google Plus, April 2019, kicking the bucket in 9 days, so gotta hurry with your last Google Plus post. Google Plus was an internet based social network. It was almost 9 years old. Yeah, as usual, probably Google trying to copy everything, get a percent market share of everything they can possibly get into. Inbox by Gmail, April 2019, kicking the bucket in 9 days. inbox by Google aimed to improve emails through several key features. It was almost 4 years old. Slightly wonder why they can't get this additional features to their primary services more popular, but whatever. Fabric, another one bites the dust in 2 months. Fabric was a platform that helped mobile teams build better apps, understand their users and grow their business. It was over 4 years old. Not really sure if I've ever heard about this one, but as usual, not really the greatest fan of giving all my Google all my data. To start with, Google Fusion Tables, amazing name, never heard about that one either. December 2019, so you have most of this year probably to use it. Dead as a doorknob in 8 months. Google Fusion Table was a web service for data management that provided a means of visualizing data in different charts, maps, and graphs. It was over 10 years old. Yay, and we are through 148 currently killed or soon to be killed, and certainly we are hitting 150 soon. I hope you enjoyed this reading 2 hours of us and exchanging here some chat messages. I hope you enjoyed it. Hey, two hours just as predicted. And yes, one second, we are still live on YouTube. And yes, one moment. And so yeah, exactly 2 hours just expected, and I hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for all the random live streams. And I hope you enjoy this random content. My wife certainly enjoys it and makes fun of it in the background. And yeah, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And don't forget that probably tonight we have our IT bits of this week new show. If we manage to live stream this one, we have managed with 0 drop frames from an aging household interruptions. Yes, the usual stuff when you try to keep your YouTube channel running in other parts of the world with irritating people around you. And we can shortly try, of course, you see this browser is super slow with all the CPU cycles and thermal budget going to the hardware encode here. This is why you see how amazing Surface stuff is. Let's see this Wunderlist in purchase. Who purchased this? Because I really didn't. Happens to me too when I prepare videos here. And Microsoft acquired this. Interesting. Didn't remember this. So then this was not Google, this is probably why we have not found it on that list. But in contrast to peak bucking macOS, we have 0 drop frames in this amazing live stream straight from OBS from Linux. However, this ULV Core i7 only manages an optimal 25 frames here with 22 CPU load, 22%. So yeah. Thanks for watching, thanks for joining, and as usual, leave in the comments below if you have more comments to all this Google stuff, and I hope to see you soon later today for our weekly news show.